Yes, we are confident. Otherwise, we wouldn't have raised our expectations. We see the reopening in Western Europe. We have a strong Q2, as you've seen. We had a good start of Q3. That means for the season that in Western Europe, we more or less know what this year will bring. It's a bit more risky in Asia, you could argue. We know that in many parts of Asia, COVID is still a big issue, and that's what we, of course, took into our considerations. China is doing well, very well at this moment of time, and that's a bit more risky, you could argue, that over time there could develop some more cases of COVID. But for what we see now, also a strong start of Q3, we know that this year will end up between the 8%-11% EBIT improvement.
I had a robust conversation once again with the UBS economist Paul Donovan earlier on about inflation, real transitory base effects otherwise. Well, you're in a business that's seeing the real core inflation, whether it's transitory or actually something more meaningful. You've talked about warning of rising costs. What kind of inflation are you seeing, sir, and how long do you think it's going to last?
Well, first of all, we are hedged for this year, so that means that we do not see the impact of the inflation in our COGS for this moment. Maybe in the second half of the year we see a bit more, because indeed there's a steep increase of commodities like aluminium, oil-related products, and so on and so forth. Yes, we see, especially for 2022, some headwinds, and we're looking for ways to mitigate these.
Okay, so I've got to say, I've been looking forward to someone bringing a cocktail to my door, a service I haven't tried out yet. But similar to that, you are taking beer directly to consumers' doors. Tell us about this new service and how you think it fits into the overall revenue model down the track as we perhaps get out of these pandemic trends.
Yeah, it is a strong development in China. We are successful in that. We are piloting this also in two other countries. It's too early, if you like, and too small to draw any conclusion. But we think that after COVID, there's all kind of new ways of delivering products. We should be at the forefront and also understand the rules of the game that might bring to a kind of different channel that we are used to. So, but it's relatively small at this moment of time.
Okay, so I also want to pick up on the various trends we had going into the pandemic. People were seeking more boutique beers. They wanted lower alcohol content. How has some of this changed or accelerated even with the pandemic?
Well, we see alcohol-free beers really, I mean, exploding maybe is a big word, but it's doing extremely well, especially in Western Europe. I think where it was a bit of a slow start a couple of years ago, what we see now is that consumers are really seeing this as a serious alternative to beer. The quality of the brews have significantly improved. We had more over 20% increase of alcohol-free beer in the first half year, and we see very strong continuation of this trend.